doing extremely well. As promised, I'm back with this beautiful, dramatic nighttime look for Eve. At first, I thought of doing an eye look with bright blue eyeshadow, but then again, I felt like it might not go with most of the outfits. And then gold and copper and bronze are kind of regular. I really wanted to do something different for this look, so I came up with this beautiful purple smoky eye, but with less purple. Because I don't want this look to clash with any outfit. And then again, I added a little twist to this eye look by adding gold on top of the eyelids. So yes, I have so much drama going on the eyes. I kept the rest of the face on the neutral side, but I still think it's pretty good and colorful. So yes, if you want to know how to get this look, then keep on watching. As you can see, I've already done one of my eye and eyebrows, but I haven't done the foundation because I'm afraid there might be a fallout from the dark eyeshadows I'm going to use. So to start off the look, I'm going to prime my eyelids with this Fortra CC eye cream. As you can see, I've used a scotch tape as a guideline for my eye look. If you're not sure where you have to put the scotch tape, then start it from here, on the side of your nose, and angle it towards the end of the eyebrow. There you have to place the scotch tape. For this look, I'm not going to set the concealer with the powder because I'm going to use this black kajal on top of my eyelid and I'm going to smudge it out. If I use a powder and then the kajal, means it will be really difficult for me to smudge the kajal. So I'm not going to use a powder. I'm just going to apply this kajal on top of my eyelid. For this step, use a really smudgy kajal, but you don't have to drag your eyelid a lot. As you can see, I'm not going neat with the kajal, I'm just applying it. Make sure you don't go beyond the crease and to the inner corner. Now I'm going to smudge this kajal. And now I'm going to take this black eyeshadow from my Sleek Vintage Matte palette, this one. I'm particularly using this black eyeshadow instead of a matte one because this one got a bit of glitter to it. It kind of adds an extra something to the whole look. So I'm going to use this one on top of that kajal. And next, I'm going to take this deep plummy black eyeshadow, this one, and I'm going to apply it on top of the black, blending towards the crease. I'm taking this to the crease because that will add a beautiful gradient. And now I'm going to blend the edges. I'm going to intensify the plum color a bit more. And again blending. And now I'm going to take this warm brown eyeshadow. This one got a lot of pink undertones to it and I'm going to use it to blend the edges. It is going to add that warmth to the look. And it turns down the purple a little bit. And now I'm going to take this cream eyeshadow from Maybelline. This is from their Color Tattoo range and I believe this is in the shade Bold Gold. Yes, this is in the shade Bold Gold. And I'm going to take it on my finger, just a bit. And I'm going to apply it to the center of the eyelid. You don't have to be neat for this. If you want, you can definitely use a brush for this step, but I think brush gives a more kind of precise and neat application, and that is not what I'm going for. I really want this to be faded out and not so neat, if that makes sense. If you feel that you have applied too much of gold, then go back with that purple eyeshadow and just lightly dab it on top of the gold. There's no way you can mess up this look, guys, because this look is already so messy and really undone. And also very simple, I believe. And now I'm going to take off this tape. I'm going to soften this edge a little bit because I really want that sharp edge, but a bit soft. And now I'm going to clean off these edges, and I'll be doing the concealer before the lower lash line. I'm just going to use my beauty blender to blend the concealer. And now I'm going to do the foundation, and for the foundation I'm going to use my MAC Studio Fix foundation. The only thing I don't like about this foundation is it doesn't come with a pump. I'm just going to take a bit the back of my hand. And now I'm going to set everything with this MAC Studio Fix powder. And to finish off the eyes, I'm going to take this Maybelline Colossal Kajal and I'm going to apply it to my low waterline and upper waterline, and also I'm going to smudge it on my lower lash line. And now I'm going back with this purple eyeshadow and I'm going to smudge the Kajal with this one. Now I'm going to do the same thing what I have done on top of my eyelids. I'm going to take this warm brown eyeshadow and I'm going to blend the edges to get more diffused look. If you want, you can totally add that gold cream eyeshadow in the center of the lower lash line as well. It will look totally beautiful. But I'm going to stop it here and I'm going to highlight my inner corner and brow bone. And for that, I'm going to use this gold eyeshadow from the same shade palette. And now I'm going to finish off the lashes with mascara and false lashes. And the lashes I'm going to use today are these red cherry lashes in number 110. And that finishes the eyes. For the face, I'm going to take this Balm Bahama Mama bronzer and I'm going to slightly contour my cheeks with this. For the blush, I'm going to use this blush from Maybelline. This is in the shade Creamy Cinnamon. This is like a nice, peachy, neutral shade blush. And next I'm gonna align my lips with this Bourjois lip liner. It is in the shade 12. And I'm going to fill my lips with this Givenchy lipstick in the shade 103. And to finish off this look, I'm going to use this Balmain Luminizer highlighter just on the highest points of my face. So this is the finished look, guys. I hope you had fun watching this video and find this tutorial helpful. Do share your thoughts on this look in the comments below. And yes, if you like the video, give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And also come and follow me on my other social media. All the links are in the description box. And yes, I will see you in my next video. Bye.